What's up, y'all? How y'all doing? Welcome back to another video. I'm your boy, Jay Bird, aka Mr. Cool Guy. With this video, we're reviewing two compilation CDs by Michael Jackson. One that came out 11 years ago, the other one that came out 8 years ago. And these albums are called Michael and Xscape. And with this video, I call it Michael versus Xscape. I'm debating like which album is better and why do people say that it's the best, but Michael has some interesting songs on here, but it was a lot of criticization, say like 3 songs on the album, one him singing, such as Keep Your Head Up, Monster featuring 50 Cent, and Breaking News. And I went on YouTube and Amazon Music, they're erased it, all 3 of those tracks from the track list if people look up this album. And I'm gonna play like the best songs from each from off the albums, and I'm not gonna play all the tracks though, but I'm gonna play like what songs I really think that are good on this record, Michael, songs that are really good on this album, Xscape. So we're gonna start playing songs for each record. So here we go, y'all. Starting with a few songs from Michael. Okay, let's start with, what song did I really feel on this record? How about track 1, Hold My Hand, sing off the album.
Yeah.
Now, this song, Hold My Hand, duet with Akon, even though him and Akon recorded this song back in 2007, and I say it's good that people did not complain saying that it was Michael singing on this song, even though he recorded it back in 2007, and Akon written this song for him, and I really like all the piano, slow rhythm come together with R&B and pop, and I say they did good with mixing it up a little with this version, even though I heard the previous version where it was just, I guess it was just Michael singing the first verse, then Akon singing the second verse, then it didn't really have a longer part to it though, but the song is good, I really like it, and I gotta say it's one of the best songs on this record, Michael. So you all can tell me what y'all like about that track, please share. Alright, moving on, track two. Hollywood Tonight, another best song on the record.
Hollywood Tonight,
A lot of people said one of him singing the song, but that is most definitely his voice, though. And I know he recorded, I did my research on this song. He recorded back in 2007 as well. And it was like a Billie Jean drum pattern sound to it. Just like if you guys seen the video, it's got that Billie Jean drum bass as the song played, and it sounds completely different. And I'd say the song is pretty good, though. And when I first heard this album 11 years ago, a lot of people were saying, like, they weren't sure if that was Michael singing on track 2, Hollywood Tonight. But I think it was him, and I really liked that single off the album. And it sucks it didn't get played on radios, though, but the song is excellent. I really rate it as one of the best songs off the album. And you all can tell me, like, if y'all rate number 2, Hollywood Tonight, one of the best songs off of this album or not. Okay, well, they don't have track 3, Keep Your Head Up, but I'm not really going to play the whole album. We're going to skip to number 4, and then number 6, and then number 9 and 10. Here we go. Okay, let's skip.
Thank you.
Now, this song, track four, I Like the Way You Love Me. I know he recorded this song like in the 80s, and I heard the original version on the Ultimate Collection, and it's good that they added a little remix to this song, and it got like a lot of pop, R&B, and more piano rhythm in the beginning of the song, and I actually feel that, and they add a few extra touches to the song, having like the chorus part played around the end of the song. But I heard the original version when it was just him just doing that all the way until the end of the song, though, and it wasn't no chorus part playing after the original version, though. But it's good that they did put a chorus part on the ending of the song, though, and I actually like it. It's good that this song is a single off the album. I wish it could have been like a dedication video to this track, though, but I don't know. I guess the people who were in charge of releasing this album, like his estate and Sony, I gotta say, like, the track is very good. I really like it. It's got like a lot of R&B and pop come together, and you walk to something like, y'all think a track for y'all rate that as one of the best, because I do. It's an interesting song that they put on the record. Alright, well, I'm gonna go to YouTube and play Monster, even though, matter of fact, let's just check to see if they have it on there. I'm not sure. Okay, let's go. Let's see if they have it. They probably deleted it. I don't know. This is the song that I like, though, but I don't know if it's Michael singing it, but the song is good, though. It could be somebody posing as him, I don't know.
Thank you.
Okay, now track 5, Monster, featuring 50 Cent. The song is good though, but everybody might be right though. I don't know if that's him singing the song though, but I gotta say, that did not sound like Michael at all though. But I thought that they took every song off every YouTube page, but I guess not though. But they took all 3 songs off of certain pages, like the main pages that are linked to his YouTube account, I guess. Like, that song, it's good though, but I don't know what to think. Like, 50 Cent verse was dope though, but whoever this Jason Mraul guy is, like, he shouldn't have done that, trying to pose as the king of pop while finishing his unreleased song that he didn't do before he passed though, I guess. But I really like the beat, I really like all the pop and the hip hop in that track, but I just don't like that guy is posing as Michael on this track. And it's good that his family and his kids know his vocals and how he sound when he sings though. I gotta say that song, I give it a C minus, cause I don't like that anybody's posing as the king of pop. And I did thought it was the best song, but I think it's not anymore, cause after all the criticization about those 3 tracks that don't sound like Michael vocals at all. But you all can tell me what y'all think of track 5, Monster. Y'all think that song good, or y'all just don't like that someone is posing as the king of pop? Please share. Alright, moving on, track 6, Best of Joy.
I am your joy, your best of joy. I am the moon that you are the spring. My life's a sacred thing. You know I always will love you. I am forever. I am the one who came when you fell down. I was the only one around. The only one. I am forever. Wasn't it I who said you are free?
Now, this track, Best of Joy, I know it's like a remix song from his previous song that he done in the 80s called The Toy, and it got the same lyrics and everything, and I heard the 2007 remix, the original version of this song, Best of Joy, and it's good that Michael got a chance to record it before he died, though, and I know this song was supposed to be on his This Is It soundtrack, but I guess after he passed away 13 years ago, his estate agreed to put it on this album, Michael. And I think this should have been a single off the album as well, though. And I really like all the style and technique that Michael did with this song. It's a beautiful song to listen to and dedicate to somebody. And I don't know if he was dedicating this song to his kids or maybe his family. I don't know. But the song is very touchy and I really like it. And I rate it as one of the best songs on the album. And you all can tell me what y'all think of track 6 in the comments below. Okay, I'm gonna play track 9. We're gonna skip track 7, Breaking News, and track 8, Can't Make It Another Day, featuring Lenny Kovacs. I ain't really vibe with that song, but the song is alright though. But you all can tell me what y'all think of those two tracks, track 7, Breaking News, and track 8. Okay, track 9, Behind the Mask. Here we go. Sorry for talking too fast, guys. I apologize. We'll be right back. Now, this song, Behind the Mask, I know they just recently put this on the Thriller 40th Anniversary Edition. It's kind of like a mic mix demo version of the song, though. And I know that's this song's supposed to be for the Thriller album, but it's good that they remixed this song and added like a little more rock and pop together with a little soul and R&B come together with disco funk. And I gotta say, this is an interesting joint off the album, and I seen that they did a dedication video to this track, Behind the Mask, how everybody posted clips of wearing masks and you know, doing a tribute to the King of Pop's legacy, and plus this song. And I don't know why they did not play this song on radio, even though this was a banging hit off the album. And I actually like it, and it's good that people did not complain and say that this song did not sound like Michael singing it, because this is totally his voice, and he recorded the song in the 80s. And I know a few producers like Teddy Riley and Rodney Jenkins and a few other people who collaborated with Michael on his music did good with track 9, and I really rate that as another interesting song off the album. You all can tell me, y'all think of track 9, is that one of y'all favorites? Y'all last single, please share. Alright, moving on, we're gonna play the final track of the album, track 10, Much Too Soon. Here we go, y'all. Okay, now this song, track 10, Much Too Soon, I know he recorded this song back in 1991 when it was around him doing the Dangerous album. And I gotta say, this is the remix version of this song, and I heard the original version. The original version was good, though. I really like all the style and technique what Michael did with writing that version, and they did good with remixing this song, making it like a lighter beat with R&B and pop come together in slow rhythm with the whole guitar solo and instruments playing, and when I play this song, it makes me think of summer, spring, or, you know, just looking at how beautiful a sunset is when it's nice outside on a beautiful day. And I say this song is very interesting. I rate this as another interesting track off the album, and I really like it. And I think this should have been another single off the record as well. And you all can tell me, like, we all think of track 10 much too soon. Do y'all like that this is an interesting song to close the album with? Or do y'all like the how it sound with all the slow R&B rhythm coming together with pop and all that? And you all can tell me, we all rate this song as the best or the worst. Y'all just like that as an interesting song to close the album with. Please share. Alright, well, we just reviewed the best songs on this album, Michael. And I already told you what I like about those tracks and the songs, the three songs such as Keep Your Head Up, Monster, and Breaking News. I'm not too sure about them tracks anymore, though, but you all can tell me, like, do y'all think those songs are fake, or y'all think somebody was posing as Michael, even though they say his name was Jason Maruo? And the beat of the songs are good, though, but I just don't know what to think of those, even though it was a big lawsuit about this record against Sony. And I don't know if Michael Jackson estate agreed of them songs being on the record. And this guy, Eddie Casco, and his tracks are gotta be fakes, though, and it don't really sound like Michael, though, but it said that he recorded those tracks in 2007 in the basement at Eddie Casco house, I guess, but I don't know. But this album, it's okay, though, but I wouldn't say it's a better album than Xscape, because Xscape, people didn't really complain about saying that Michael didn't sing on these records. And in the next video, we're going to review all the best songs on this album, Xscape. And I already told you what I think of Michael, and I rate Michael as an okay album, but they should have put songs that he actually done before his death on this album instead of adding fakes, I guess. But you all can tell me what y'all think of this album. Is it the best or worst? See, I just rate it as a terrible record that came out 10 years ago. So y'all tune into the next video. We're going to review best songs off of Xscape. And I'm your boy Jay Bird, aka Mr. Cool Guy, coming to you with a double album, Michael versus Xscape. See y'all in the next video.